Pretty girl, Abigail. Mwah. Pretty girl.
Hi, hi, hi. Welcome back. It's 3 o'clock in the morning and I kind of forced myself to sit here and just create something. And here is what I came up with. So that's what this tutorial is all about. So if you wanna see how I got this look, then just keep on watching.
Here we are. We are starting off with this cream shadow from Huda. I'm just going to blend this into the crease and I'm just going to add a little bit more to kind of make that, what would you call it? It's like aqua blue, turquoisey color, very opaque. So I'm just going to blend that into the crease and really focus it on the inner corners. And then we are going to move on to our next shade. I'm gonna be jumping into the Morphe James Charles palette and I'm gonna be using a lot of this blue right here. I'm gonna be blending this into the crease and mainly the outer corner of the eye. At this point in time, guys, I had no idea what I was going for. I kind of just forced myself to sit down and just film. So that's what you're getting here today. So I'm just gonna keep going back and forth into that shadow and just keep packing that on. And then I went in with a clean blending brush just to kind of help everything blend together. And surprisingly, these Huda shadows are really great. They did blend pretty well. I'm gonna go into just my Tarte Shape Tape concealer and I'm gonna place that on the inner corner and start creating that half cut crease. So I'm just taking a little bit off the back of my hand and I'm creating that cut crease with a flat shader brush. And you can also see this super, super, super thin skinny brush that I have from Daco, D-A-C-O, which is actually an artist's like painting brand that is really, really amazing. They have super, super, super tiny thin brushes. So I use that to help me create the perfect cut crease. And then going into some shades from the James Charles palette, I used the lightest shimmery blue in the inner corner and then I'm using this turquoise color on the outer part of where we put that cut crease. And then I used some of this shimmery blue just to kind of help blend that turquoise with the darker blue on the outer corner. And then I'm using this beautiful Makeup Forever shade that I have. I listed everything down below. I'm not sure if they make this shade anymore because I remember that Makeup Forever changed their single shadows, but I named it down below. So hopefully you guys can find it and get your hands on it because it's beautiful. I went back to that Huda shadow and used the glittery shade on the opposite side of the cream shadow. And then I'm just adding some lime green eyeliner from the brand called Suva Beauty. So you just wet the brush a little bit and then put it in the paint and apply it. I love these hydro liners. They're absolutely amazing, and I love the way that this one came out on top of this blue. It was just super opaque and really wasn't hard to work with at all. I'm then gonna go to this Makeup Forever Artist Color Pencil and apply this light blue shade to my waterline. And then I'm gonna apply some Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara and of course apply some lashes to this look because it would not be complete without falsies. So the lashes I use are from Tarte. And then we're gonna jump over to our face as we always do. I'm using the Yensa primer. And then I'm gonna use the No Problem primer from Touch and Soul. And I'm just gonna blend that all over my entire face before we put on our foundation. For foundation, the foundation I chose for this look is the Dior Forever Undercover foundation. I haven't used this in a minute. So I'm just going to apply a mix 020 and 030 onto my face, mix them together. I don't know why, but 020 and 030 are very, very far apart in color, so wanted to mix them to get the perfect shade. I'm then applying my NARS Creamy Concealer in Custard, and I'm really gonna apply a ton of this so that we can have a really, really full coverage face because we're gonna be doing lots of fun stuff in just a little bit. So excited for you guys to see if you didn't see it already, because I know I posted a sneak peek to Instagram. So after we blended that all out, I'm using my Cover FX setting powder to set underneath my eyes and in all of my T-zone areas. And then I'm using my MAC Mineralize Skin Finish powder to set everything else on my face. I've been really loving this combination of setting powders recently. It does not look cakey. It does not look like too overdone. And the Mineralize Skin Finish is just perfect for that like more dewy, natural look. I'm then going to apply some waterproof mascara from Neutrogena to the bottom lashes and also, of course, my shadows. And then I applied some brow mascara from Milk Makeup to my brows. For bronzer, I'm using the Park Ave Princess bronzer from Tarte. And I'm just going to bronze up my entire face with that bronzer. And then for blush, I'm using the Bare Minerals Gen Nude Blush. I can't think of the color right off the top of my head, but it's in the description, I promise. Then I'm using the Champagne Pop Highlighter from Becca, and I'm applying this absolutely everywhere. And then I took this lighter shade from the James Charles palette and applied that to the inner corners as well as the brow bone. And then I just went away for a little bit and did my hair in a half up, half down. And now we're gonna add the glitter fam. Comment down below if you're part of the glitter fam. Let me know you made it this far into the video. So I had this really cute collection of glitter from the Gypsy Shrine, I think is what the name is called. And I just decided to place that all over my hair. Mainly on the sides, a little bit on the top, and then where I kind of laid the baby hairs down, I'm applying more of that MAC Trolls glitter and then some of that BH Cosmetics glitter. I'm going to set everything with my Wet n Wild Coconut Spray Mist, make sure it's all dry, and then I'm going to apply more of that BH Cosmetics glitter. And then all of these flowers you guys are going to see me apply are from Michaels, including the butterflies. I would suggest applying with lash glue, but apply the lash glue first to your face. I don't know, I've always had this problem with like these little flowers that I use from Michaels. They just don't stick really well with lash glue, or to be honest with you, anything. So it takes a little bit. I think it's just a mix of the material and everything like that. And now you can see me just rubbing the glitter on the rest of my body to kind of bring the look together. It's just mixed with the Tresemme hair gel, and it sticks pretty good. And now we're going to stick on the butterflies. I did the same thing with the butterflies. I just put some lash glue down to stick it to my face. Like I said, it was a little difficult, but we made it work. And then using this Aaliyah lip pencil from MAC, and it's just a super, super dark color. I think it's called Nevermore. I'm gonna apply that all over my lips, and then I'm gonna apply this beautiful lipstick from MAC. It's called On and On, and it's kind of like an iridescent light blue purple. And on top of that, I'm gonna apply what I like to call this Cinderella lip gloss from MAC as well to give it a really, really pretty look. And then I added some more of that BH Cosmetics glitter on top, more setting spray, and this is the completed look. I hope you guys like it, and I hope you like the creativity. Again, I kind of forced myself to sit down and create this for you, but I hope it came together and inspires you guys.
Thank you guys for tuning in to this video and joining the Glitter Queen Chronicles at 3 o'clock in the morning, because you know that's when all the creative juices just have to be flowing at 3 o'clock in the morning. but I hope you guys enjoyed this creative look. I keep getting lipstick on my teeth. I'm gonna go to bed and try to sleep and wake up at a normal hour like a normal human being. But I hope you guys liked this look. Thank you so much for tuning in. As always, make sure to subscribe to me, you know, me, the glitter queen, right here in the center of the screen, and check out all of my other videos right here on the side. Love you guys to the moon and back. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.